I've recorded a quick demo. It will go through the process of creating a cloud router, creating a connection to AWS, creating a connection to Microsoft Azure, and then doing a simple ping test between two virtual machines running in each of those cloud environments, as well as an iPerf test to kind of show the throughput. So the first thing we're going to do here is create a Fabric Cloud Router. So we're in the Fabric portal, and here in the top nav, we can create a Fabric Cloud Router. We're going to select the location or metro we want to use and select the billing account. The next thing we need to do is give our Fabric Cloud Router a name. Optionally, we can also specify a purchase order number. It's an optional field. And then the customer will select what package they want to use. These packages are on an internal account, so some of the naming and pricing you may see will be different once it goes is commercialized here next week. So as you can see, it was a couple steps there creating the cloud router, and that instance is typically created within 5 to 10 seconds. After that, we're going to create a connection first to AWS. When we'll use the quick connect experience, I'm going to create a single primary connection just for the purposes of the demo. And we're going to select Ashburn or Washington, D.C. I'll put in my AWS account number, select the cloud router that I want to originate the connection from, select the bandwidth, and give my connection a name. After that, I'll go ahead and create that connection. And the layer two connectivity portion of that connection is almost complete. The next step here on the AWS side is to go in and accept that connection. So I've accepted the connection, and I'm going to create a virtual interface in AWS. This step is a little bit different from cloud provider to cloud provider. AWS uses this approach. There's a little bit more configuration involved. So I'm specifying what I want my BGP addresses to be. I can specify an optional BGP authentication key. I'm just using Equinix. And I enable jumbo frames. So my virtual interface is configured now. I'm going to go to the Equinix side and configure my layer three connectivity or my routing details within my AWS connection. So you'll see that layer two is configured. We're pending interface configuration. So we'll go to routing details, configure routing. I'm going to specify the same IP addresses that I indicated in the AWS portal. I'm going to specify the AWS ASN that I selected, my authentication key, and apply those changes. The next thing here is I'm going to validate my AWS connectivity. So everything's up, everything's showing green. We're provisioned. BGP is provisioned. Everything's looking good. Then we're going to navigate to our cloud router we created earlier and view our active routes. And we see now that we're receiving a route from AWS 172.31/16. So everything's looking good. Now we're going to go to the Azure side of this connection. I'm going to create an express route. We'll give this express route a name. We'll select port type provider. We're going to use Equinix here. I'm going to select Washington, D.C. and select my bandwidth. After that, we'll create this express route circuit. And then once this is complete, we'll be provided with an Azure key, which you'll see in the next step here. So from the Azure portal, once that express route is established and ready to use, you'll get an express route key. I'll plug in that Azure service key. It's going to validate the service key. It'll carry over some information via some provider APIs we have with Microsoft. And so that it sees it's for Ashburn, it's for 50 meg. And then from here, I select the cloud router that I want to attach this connection to. And on the Azure side, by default, they do redundant connections. And so you'll see I have a primary and a secondary connection. And I just gave those connection names, and I selected the peering type private, and we're now creating that connection. Next step is configure routing details for the Azure side. We're almost there, team, just a few more steps here. So similar to the Azure, similar to the AWS connection, we'll configure the interface addresses and the BGP information as well. This is the Azure ASN and our authentication key. The last step we have to do here is configure private peering on the Azure side. So we'll use our Ashburn Equinix ASN. Use the same subnets that we configured in the previous screen and our pre-shared key. Now we're going to verify that we see routes from both AWS and Azure. We see three connections. We go to our active routes. And we now have routes from each connection from Azure and one from AWS. And now here's a quick little test showing connectivity between AWS and an Azure VM. So you can see roughly 2 milliseconds of latency. And then I'm going to run a quick iperf server on my Azure environment and then run iperf as a client on the AWS side. You can see 48.3 megabit. Cool. So that was it for the demo.